This we will create a program using the list. Okay, so this is where we start with our program. So this is just like a container wherein you can store different types of data. Okay, so we'll be using the Python. So in Python, you have there the five standard data types. You have the numbers, you have the string, you have the tuples, you have the list, and of course, we have the dictionary. Okay, so these are the things that we need to understand when we are using what? Python. Now, in my previous tutorial, I have here the list discussion, but again, we'll be using the simple and basic list. Like for example, how to find the duplicates of records of data, duplicates of data, of, sorry, duplicates of data inside the list. Okay, so that's the question. So we can use a very simple program. At the same time, well, of course, we need first to understand how the list works. Like for example, we have here x equals 2. Okay, so this is the simple instructions for the list. Okay, you can find this explanation in my previous lesson. Okay, all you have to do is to check my Python playlist. For example, if we want to append the data, append, and of course, 1. Okay, we can say print. Okay, sorry, print x. So here, we have here the variable x that will handle the list. At the same time, this is blank. And of course, if we add the data, this is now the method to add the list of 1, of the integer. 1. Okay, now if we run the program automatically, we have here, okay, we have here the list of 1. Okay, now for example, if you want to add another list, x append, let's say hello, so we can combine numbers and integers inside the list. So print, okay, this is the new list. Okay, so we print again, print x. Okay, let us check that and run the program. So using our terminal, so we have here 1 and hello. Okay, let's say we want to remove the list. Well, of course, if you can add and append, you can use also the principles of your database application, just like you are using the CRUD. CRUD stands for create, read, update, and delete. Okay, you can store your data in a state what less type of container. So we are using the list as part of our stateless data. Okay, let's say we need to remove the value of 1. How to do that? So this is what, the offset of 1 is 0, the offset of hello is 1. If you want to remove, that's very simple. How to do that? You can use del, and then you have there x, and then the offset of that data is in 0. So let us check that. Okay, now when we run the program, okay, let us check it. Okay, so you have the output, but we were not able to display the new value of this. Let us display it. Okay, here. Then we run the program again. So as you can see, we don't have the value of 1 anymore because 1 is what? Is in the offset of 0. Okay. Again, you can use also the what? X.remove. Okay, this is part of your list method. We have also the x dot clear. Okay, I cannot recall it anymore, but well, all you have to do is to check it. Okay, now what will happen? This time we create a little program to what? To check if we have duplicate inside the list. Like for example, we have your list 1. Okay, let us erase this first. So we have to erase this first. Okay, let's say we have here the list. Okay, so we have here the duplicates of 12, 12, 1, 2, 3. For example, these are the contents of the list. Okay, if you print that, okay, x, okay, what will happen? So when we run the program, okay, we have here the content of the list, 12, 12, 2, 3, 3, 4. What will happen if we want to check the duplicate is on the list? Okay, so we will use the list method. So the list method is to use the count. Okay, how to use that? For example, we have here, we have dip, let's say dip duplicates. Okay, that will be the variable, and then we have here x dot count. Let's say in this count we need to provide the integer. So let's say we have to provide, we need to infuse 2. So this 1, this 2 integer, or this 2 number 2 will search for the duplicates inside the list. Okay, all right. So when we print the duplicates, print, okay, these are the the numbers with duplicates. Okay. So if we print that, well, of course we have here the value of tip what? Duplicates. Okay, let us check the spelling. Okay, when we run the program. Alright, so we have there. These are the numbers with duplicates 1. Well, okay, let us check that. 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. Let us check this. Okay, let us try this number, 5. Okay, so we have number 5. It will display the value of what? 3. Okay, 3 duplicates. So we have the duplicates of 3 because we have 3, number 5. Okay, that's how you do it. So this is part of the method. Okay, what if we are going to write our own function to find the duplicates inside the list? So by writing the function, of course, you need to use the def. The function is like a smart program wherein you can use that in the main program of your Python. Okay, for example, we have here the def. For example, how to write a function. For example, we have here def, and then we will use add data. So we will create a parameter here, x and y. Okay, the purpose of this is to represent any value, any operands in your main program. And then we return the value of x plus y. So this x plus y is just like, you know, returning any data or any numbers in the main program. This will represent any operands or integers. Now, if you run this program, okay, print, let's say. So we have here the return value of two parameters, 1, 2. And then we what? Write the code here. Let's say add data. The purpose of this function is to what? Get the total of the number, get the sum of the number. Okay, a function is like a cookie cutter. Okay, a tool. Now we need to produce the first value of x, 1, this is the first parameter, it represents x. And then, like for example, we have there 10. This represents, of course, the value of what? Y. If we print this program, okay, what will happen? So the answer is 1 plus 10, that is 11. Okay, now if we add another what you call this codes here, print, okay, the return, the sum is, okay, let's say, so this will what? Print the sum. Okay, now when we run again the program, it will what? Display the sum and of course the value of x and y, adding what? 1 and 10. So when we run the program, okay, so that is the sum is what? 11. So that's the answer. Now let us go back, because our main target here is to write a program that will what? That will find the duplicates. Okay, so we can use this count, but again, well, of course this is basic. We need to what you call this, to expand our program. Okay, now let us erase this thing. How to do that? Okay, start to write the function. Okay, so the keyword here is, well, of course we have the list. At the same time, we need to create the function, and we need to use the control using what? Well, of course, we can use the loops to reiterate our data to find the numbers inside the list and compare the numbers inside the length of the function, length of the variable. Okay, let us start with the program. So let us first start with the def. So we can say, well, of course, we have here the loops, and then we create a variable. Okay, xx is our variable here, sorry, xx. Okay, what's next? So we need to define the variable. The variable is just like we need to define the fixed length of the xx inside the parameter. So we have here the parameter. This will display what you call this, the list. Okay, now let us enter that. And then we have here, let's say, data size. Okay, this will be our variable. And then we use the length. And then this is where we encapsulate the value of xx inside the parameter. Okay, let us create our variable here for the list. This is an empty list. Later on, we will what? Use this as part of our process to what? To append our list inside for the duplicates. Okay, let us look. Okay, so for example, we have here for I in range. So we have here range from what? Well, of course, we have here from your data size. Okay, and then we need to create another variable. What is that variable? Well, of course, j. We can use any variable here. For example, like j increment, okay? We have here I plus 1, okay? This is where to read the data inside the list and find, of course, the duplicates, okay? Next is, again, we need to loop. So we have here the outer and, of course, we have here the inner loop, all right? Now, what will happen? For, let's say, we have here, let's say, k equals in range. So it starts with j inc. And then, of course, this is the starting point, the range. And we need to what? Measure what? Sorry. Measure the, oops. Oh, wait. Common problem. Okay. Sorry about that. So we have to measure the j inc. And then we need to define the size. Okay. Now, we need to compare the value. If xx, because xx is part of the parameter, so fxx, what list? Of course, at the top of that, we will use I, okay, equals equals 2, and then xx, we have here, what you call this, the k, alright, and xx, okay, not in, if it is not inside the loops, okay, here, in our list, we will append the data, okay, we will append the data right here, okay, so we will append it right here, so we'll use loop, that append, and then, of course, we will use the xxi, okay, xxi, that is the top, the size of the list, and then, otherwise, we'll, of course, we will return the value of the loop at the bottom. So this is the loop. Loop is our list. Okay. Now let us go back to the main part of the program because we are following the indention. You go back here in the main indention. It's very important. We are following the indention to avoid errors. We have the parent, the child, and subchild statement. That is the rule in Python. So we will declare a variable here to create the list. For example, lst1. Let's say lst1. First, let us create a variable here with the list. Okay, let's say 3, 44, 34. So we will combine different types of data here with duplicates. Okay, so what will happen if we have the duplicates? Okay, and then we will print the data. Okay, what is that data right there? We need to call again, of course, the functions that we created at the top that will return the value of what? A parameter with, okay, the duplicates inside the list. Alright, so what will happen? So the name of the function is dops. Okay, let us do that. Dops. Then we have here, of course, let's say we have to involve what? Dops. Involve the disk one. Okay. Okay, so this is now the program. Okay, a little up in Python to find the duplicates of the list by using the functions. So we have here the statements for the array of or for the list, I mean, and we need to use the loop to read, of course, the data inside the list. Okay, program. Okay, so we need to go here at the same time. Okay, I think there's a problem right here. So there is no items displayed as duplicate right here. So let us check our program. Okay, so we have here, I think this is about the indention. Let's go here. Alright, that's it. So this is to end the loop and same time return the value of loop and then print the value of the duplicates here. Alright, so when we run the program, alright, let us run the program again. So we have here run Python. So we have here 3, 34, 23. Let's review. So we have how many duplicates here? 3. 3. Okay. So we have here the 3 duplicates. Okay. 3. And then we have 34. And we have also what? 23. And we have 12. Okay, so that's it. This is your simple program for finding the list. And of course, if you want to check again my Python tutorial, well, of course, you can check the description below. Okay, please don't forget to share, like, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much.